Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the weekly show with Aditya, India's number one podcast, with India's number one host, Aditya.
Coming to you live every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
In association with Dusra.net, the number one website in sports, education, and entertainment.
With the World Cup only 61 days away, tensions are on a all-time high. Auditions are being taken to finalize spots for the World Cup. And in this context, the final ODI, that is the fifth ODI between India and Australia, assumes a lot of importance. Though Pant and Rahul deserve to be in the playing 11, but let's be realistic as to what the people who matter think. The selection committee, the captain and the coach are the people who are going to make the final decision who will be part of the 20-member team that goes to the World Cup. And out of these 20, who will play in the final 11? This will be the first time that two all-rounders, both accomplished in batting and bowling, are going to the World Cup after a gap of 36 years. But in the 1983 team, we had the likes of Madanlal, Roger Bidd, Mohinder Amarnath, who were called all-rounders, but they were only bits and pieces bowler who by a stroke of luck got themselves wickets. But the only all-rounder in that team was Kapil Dev. With the record he had, with the attitude he had, and the way he led his team with panache. Nor did we have two accomplished wicketkeepers. One who has proven himself for the past 15 years, and this individual's resume speaks for itself, while the other one is building up a resume which will put many so-called pseudo-critics to shame. One needs to understand that hyping this Pant situation about him dropping catches or missing stumpings shows that we have a short memory, that we are not being fair to this individual who is only 21 years old. And remember that when Kohli was also around that age, he did not begin with a bang. In fact, we weren't even comparing him to Tendulkar 7 or 8 years ago. It was only post 2012 and 2013 that when Tendulkar finally left, that he became the batsman that he is, and now his record speaks for itself. Now we cannot imagine a team without Virat Kohli. While Tendulkar's counterparts from other countries were talented and good, like we had Jack Kallis from South Africa, we had up to some extent Inzamam ul Haq or a Mohammad Yusuf from Pakistan, Ricky Ponting from Australia, up to some extent, yes, Brian Lara was also good. But now the counterparts that Kohli has are head and shoulders above the rest, and they have put their future batsmen on notice that breaking their records will require some effort. So let's line up Kohli's counterparts. Who can forget Steve Smith with an average of 60 with 20 centuries? Yes, he has not played for 1 year for reasons which are harsh, but you have Smith and Warner from Australia. We can add Peter Handscomb, Travis Head, Joe Burns. These individuals are now giving Kohli a run for their money. Kane Williams, Tom Latham from New Zealand, Then we have Ross Taylor, who has been doing his job for the past 15 years and now holds the record for most centuries and most runs for New Zealand. Who can forget Joe Root? Smith, Warner, Williamson, Taylor, Latham, Root. Match Kohli in every department, that is fielding, bowling, batting, and they have also been captains of their respective teams. And now the ones who are coming up are, you have a Babar Azam from Pakistan, whose record in a short time is envious of what Kohli would do when he was young. A team like South Africa is blessed to have great wicketkeepers, and in my book there are only two great wicketkeepers for South Africa. We had Mark Boucher with close to 150 test matches. For a guy coming at number 8 or number 9, he used to be that individual from whom we were not expecting much of batting, but he was a flawless keeper, and then whenever he got a chance, he would make runs. He has over 500 catches in test matches and also an equal envious record in one-day matches. Now, South Africa are continuing their legacy with Quinton de Kock. And the best part of Quinton de Kock is that he is an opener and a keeper. So yes, there will be pressure on him to keep up the legacy, and comparisons to Adam Gilchrist will loom large. But let me tell you, I have seen both Adam Gilchrist and Quinton de Kock bat, and I feel that Quinton de Kock is not only talented, but he is a superior keeper to Adam Gilchrist. It is irrelevant whether Gilchrist played in the 90s and Quinton de Kock made his debut in the more acceptable version of 2010s and plus. He is captaincy material, and once Francois du Plessis or Faf du Plessis calls it a day, my nomination for the captain of South Africa will be Quinton de Kock, at least for the one-day matches. And for test matches, it will be either Dean Elgar or Aidan Markram. Let's continue this discussion by talking about the captains in this World Cup. From India, it's Virat Kohli. For South Africa, it's Faf du Plessis. For West Indies, yes, I am saying West Indies, not that term Windies, which is an absolute ignorant way of calling the team. It is the all-rounder and the best all-rounder West Indies ever had. And yes, one who is much better than a Gary Sobers. That is, this all-rounder is Jason Holder. From England, it is Owen Morgan. Yes, Morgan is the captain for another ignorant way of saying 50 overs and 20 overs white ball. And Root is the captain for red ball. So should India also split their captaincy in 50 overs, 20 overs and test matches? In my view, yes. Especially they should give the captaincy of the 20 over version to Rohit Sharma. And in my viewpoint, post the 2020 World Cup, Kohli should call it off in the 2020 version if he wants to play a couple of World Cups, that is the 50 over World Cups in the near future. In terms of captaincy, India have had only three great captains. It all started with Sourav Ganguly, who actually brought the real meaning of captaincy when he became the captain, while the ones before him were only fillers and not much record to talk about, with absolute zero attitude for winning. They were the most idle and most boring captains India had ever seen before Ganguly actually made captaincy a thing to talk about when it came to being an Indian spectator. Dhoni continued that legacy for 9 years, and now Kohli will hope to continue that legacy and seal it with a World Cup win. While Ganguly brought the team to the World Cup final before his decision of deciding to field first. In the 2003 World Cup final, Dhoni took it one step further when he took the team to the final and also got the team the trophy. Now it is up to Kohli to make sure that he carries on the legacy of these two legendary captains. He did it almost when India were in the Champions Trophy or the Mini World Cup final in 2017. But like Ganguly, something happened and he decided to field first. And it was a deja vu moment. India lost the match by a big margin. So the question is, if India do make it to the World Cup finals, unless the other team wins and decides to bat first, if India wins the toss, irrespective of how the pitch is, good for batting, good for chasing and all those extra things, we should bat first, even a total of 270, 280 will be worth defending. So yes, Kohli should not make this mistake that he made 2 years ago and that Ganguly made 16 years ago. Cricket is the only game which is affected by a thing called toss. And toss becomes such an important thing, whereas it is the most unimportant and an ordinary process. Another thing which baffles me about this sport is this phenomenon called dew. What in the world is dew? The grass becomes wet. Yes, the ball quote unquote slides on to the bat. The spinners are unable to grip the ball. I think this is the most ridiculous thing that I've ever heard in any sport. And yet it becomes such a part of the match that it becomes an individual in itself. If the organizers were aware that the dew factor will impact the match, then instead of starting at 1:30, why don't you start the match at 11 a.m. There is no obligation to have a day and night match. In fact, in India, if you're having the match between January and April, one should start the match, especially the one day matches, at 11 a.m. local time and the test matches at 10 or 10:30 a.m. local time. Nowhere in the world do matches start at 9:30 a.m. Continuing with the captains of other teams, we have done with India and South Africa. Now we move on to Australia. Yes, Steve Smith will no longer be the captain. He will be just playing as an ordinary player. But Aaron Finch assumes that important role. From Pakistan, it will be Sarfaraz Ahmed. For England, it will be Owen Morgan. From New Zealand, it will be Kane Williamson. From Afghanistan, it is Asghar Stanikzai. And from Bangladesh, it will be Mashrafe Mortaza. Cricket is another game saturated with statistics. And the statistics that become so important and a talking point every time we see people discussing this sport, it is about batting averages and bowling averages. So in a way, if a bowler's average is high, then the bowler is not good enough. But if the batsman's average is low, then the batsman is ordinary and unexceptional. So for example, if Hardik Pandya is my number one all-rounder, then his bowling average should be between 20 and 25, but his batting average has to be between 40 and 45 so that he is given that hype and the exaggeration as the all-rounder. But despite our obsession with such statistics, whatever record Pandya will have in future, He and Vijay Shankar are my fast bowling all-rounders and Ravindra Jadeja is my spinning all-rounder along with Kedar Jadhav and Bhubaneswar Kumar who can be a great batsman as well. Another term that has been used far too often and is now becoming monotonous and a pain to the ears are the terms batting all-rounder or bowling all-rounder, keeper batsman or batsman keeper. These terms are absolutely needless. If you can bowl and you can bat, irrespective of whether you complete your quota of overs or not, that is not a criteria to call you a great all-rounder. In fact, this fifth bowler's quota, it doesn't matter how the captain goes about to complete. As long as we are able to achieve that target, that is what is more significant than who bowls how many overs at what economy rate, because even the economy rate is just another roving number. So in the hindsight, batting averages and bowling averages are the only topics that are left to talk about with the paucity of good commentators. And as far as commentators are concerned, there are only two good commentators in India. They are the current coach Ravi Shastri and your number one host Aditya. And along with Tony Greig, Jeffrey Boycott, Richie Beno, we form the famous five. As promised in the last episode, we are going to introduce a word of the week. And the word of the week is anti-hero, which means a central character in a story, film or play who lacks typical heroic qualities. And the example is Rishabh Pant. He is not an anti-hero, but he was made one when he dropped those catches or missed stumpings. But he is not an anti-hero. So if you want to be a part of my show, please send your valuable suggestions and send your recordings on topics ranging from sports, education and entertainment on the email ID adityathewriter@gmail.com. That is adityathewriter@gmail.com. Thank you for listening to this episode. Please like and subscribe to my Facebook page and YouTube channel and stay tuned for the next episode.